Hello? How's this? I forgot to turn on the mic. Thank you for Jinhan Labs. Thank you for reminding me. Oh. That's why sometimes you need people need a producer for this stuff. Yeah, I can't see that icon, but that's pretty much how I feel. Let's see, Nelson Aguilar. Pick almost. Des Bryant is still available. What do you think, Jinhan Labs? I'm thinking I have Des Bryant. If you can see my starting lineup, Drew Brees, Mike Evans, Will Fuller, Aguilar, Gurley, Alex Collins, Kelsey, Marshawn Lynch, Adrian Peterson is my flex. I need a kicker, defense, two defensive players. However, I have also some bench people. Yes, Dez is not on a team, I know, but you can't imagine that he's going to be on a team soon, right? The gamble is how soon and what kind of impact he's going to have on that team. So, Bad News Bears and Moy Monsters are coming up. I'm thinking, okay, I got three good wide receivers. There's Crabtree out there. Kenny Stills is still out there. Garoppolo, I would like to pick up as my backup QB. Tariq Cohen, I would like to pick up, and possibly the number one defense, Jacksonville. So I'm going to have to pick up a defense because it's not they're not going to be around next round by the time it snakes back. So maybe Kenny Stills. Let's see how everybody's ranked. Ooh, Cooper Kupp. Cooper Kupp. Cooper Kupp is still available. Okay, it's my pick. I got a minute 18. Let's see. I'm thinking Kenny Stills, Tariq Cohen. Kenny Stills and Tariq Cohen. How about that? Dolphins fan. And either Tariq Cohen or Jacksonville defense. Jacksonville defense is not going to be around by the next round. Defensive players are already going. Tevin Smith, Quan Alexander. Let's go Tevin Smith. Defensive player. Maybe the defense might be around. Team defense. This league is a lot of points, a lot of players. Two defensive players, one defense. Two flex, two running backs, three wide receivers, PPR. Hopefully Tariq Cohen will still be around, which I doubt. Make sure I queue up Rashard Jones. Let's see who else. Alright. Let's get back to drawing. We got a little bit of ways. Jin, where are you based out of? East Coast, yeah. It's late. Midnight. 1 o'clock. And tomorrow's a work day. Are you an artist as well? Hey, definitely not Dylan. I am in the office tonight. I'm going to have to be up all night tonight working. But I'm doing a fantasy football draft right now. So, in order to kill two birds with one stone, I thought I'd work on this Purdue Pete piece. This is just a piece for myself. We're actually, this is not a paid piece. This is something I thought I'd do and then post up later to show my support fandom for the Purdue Boilermakers. I hope everybody had a good holiday weekend. Oh, Jen, did you go to the Fairfax show last week? Birds are asleep now. Yeah, I was on earlier. You might be able to watch the repeat. They flew by quite often during the stream, the previous stream. So I think any day now, they're just teasing you guys. There's going to be a prize given out. Jinha. I'm giving a prize whenever I stream, I have two miniature parrots called parrots. And if they fly and land on my shoulder during the stream, both of them on my shoulder, then whoever is on the stream at that time in the chat, you get like, I don't know, 30 seconds or so, text something, write something in the chat. And if you get it in time, I will send you a prize. Most likely a print. Des Bryant is still available, along with Jimmy Garoppolo. However, Jacksonville and the Rams were off the board. Probably should have taken the defense. Well, the birds are in their cage now, right now, so there's almost zero chance that they will be coming out tonight, because the cage is locked up. But next time I stream, usually during the day, they'll be flying about, and you get an opportunity to win a prize. One of the instances where I draw digitally. I have different layers. This one is just, you know, sketch layer. I have a rough layer, and then I go back in, and it's almost like inking, penciling and inking. Previous piece I'd already drawn was actually a couple years ago. But they did not use it. Ended up using NCAA championships. I had drawn the Alabama Crimson Tide, but they had to get this done before the week, before that championship teams were selected, or, you know, based off of the winnings, based off of who won. You really think the Patriots defense would be that good? Yeah, they're available. Pittsburgh, New England, Los Angeles, Chicago. I'm thinking Chicago. New England. Rings don't lie, yeah, but it's more than just the defense. I mean, Patriots, because they got Tom Brady. If it was like yesteryears of Tampa Bay when the Buccaneers won, they had Trent Dilfer. I mean, Trent Dilfer was a guy that just didn't throw any turnovers. And he ball control, right? Time clock, team management. So and the defense wanted in that situation. I don't think the Patriots are necessarily a complete defensive team like that, although they are a great team. I think they're a very well-balanced team. Chicago, my thinking about Chicago is that because they just traded for Khalil Mack, that that's a good point. Patriots play the Jets and the Bills 4 times. I think you got me with that. I think that might work. How one player might invigorate an entire squad. All right, my pick. Got a minute 23. Jen, I am going to select the New England Patriots based off of your recommendation that they play the Jets and the Bills 4 times. This league is like $350. So if I finish last, that's another $100. I'm coming after you. But I am going to select New England Patriots. And then I got one more pick. Who is the best available? Alshon Jeffries, Isaiah Crowell, Sterling Shepard. All players. Best available all players. Rashard Jones. All right. Yes, Jinhan. If I lose, I finish last place because of the Patriots, I'm coming after you. If I win, I'll buy you a beer. I'm assuming you're old enough to drink a beer. Actually, if I win, I'll get you more than a beer. Is there a particular drink that you favor? I'm liking this team better. Tomorrow night I have one more draft. That's a keeper league. If you guys watch fantasy football, keeper leagues are leagues where you try to get the same owners back every year, and you get to keep a certain number of players from your roster. So you don't draft a brand new team. It has a much more kind of realistic feel to playing fantasy sports. This league you get to keep 4 different players. So my 4 keepers in that league or Drew Brees, Lamar Miller,
Alex Thielen, and Brandon Cooks.
You have to keep at least a reserve player in each position on that team. So you can't, like, stockpile.
You can't stockpile running backs or anything. A sketch would mean I would have to do work. Maybe.
If you catch me at the right moment, maybe. No, I can't guarantee anything. I think I should have picked the Jacksonville Jaguars earlier.
And I might have still been able to get, well, maybe not that defensive player. Defensive players actually do score a lot more points in this league. more bench players do I have? Oh, there's a lot more. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 more rounds, which would take us into maybe another hour.
45 minutes.
This is a... This league has only 10 teams, but Jinhan,
thank you very much for your help tonight. Have a pleasant sleep.
Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Yes. Give me a follow. You can click up there and let me know
so you can notify when I'm online. I'm going to try to set a regular schedule sometime this coming week or next week. The following week I'm in Spain. Try to stream while I'm there. From then on, hopefully I can set a regular weekly schedule, 1 or 2 days a week,
where you guys can catch me. I got a lot of stuff planned already, which I hope will be fun.
So thanks again, and definitely let me know throughout the season how well the Patriots are doing.
I mean, I hope they're doing well. I like the Patriots.
Good friend of mine is Tom Brady's agent, so I'm always cheering for them.
I will try to make it out to the East Coast. It's been a couple of years since I've been out there. But thank you for stopping by tonight.
Anybody else out there that's playing or following along in terms of, oh, and my next pick is coming up. These picks are coming up fast. Fast and furious. I think I'm going to have to pick up Dez Bryant. See if Garoppolo is still available. Oh no! Garoppolo's been drafted. Man. Who will be my backup QB? My starting QB is Drew Brees. I can always pick up Jared Goff. See who else. Wide receivers are available. Devontae Parker and Dez Bryant. It's Rashard Matthews. Let's see what's up with Rashard Matthews. Kelvin Benjamin. Meredith. Devontae Parker and Dez Bryant. Let's see. Who do I have? Do I have any backup running backs? I have Kenny Stills. It's a backup running back. Devontae Parker and Austin Eckler.
Now back to drawing. Definitely not Dylan. You still there? So, this streaming thing has been somewhat fun, but also frustrating. The frustrating part mostly comes from the tech aspect. And being just really confused. After every stream, I have to. Yeah, there's different kinds of fantasy football, quote unquote, games or styles of play. Each of the leagues that I play in is have different rules. So some of it is just the tech, initially getting all the stuff, making sure the stuff that I have now is compatible and works. And then having a sense of what I want the stream to look like versus A, what kind of tech do I need? What can I get away with what I have right now? Also after every stream, I have to take the setup down and pretty much start over again the next time, which so far this last... The last intervals, it's been almost 2 weeks since I streamed last, and it's not because I don't want to, it's mostly because of the scheduling with deadlines. It is extremely difficult, well, kind of restricted with what you can show online. What you're doing too, it requires a particular, I've said this many times, like a muscle to kind of get used to drawing and talking at the same time, and it's not easy. Something that requires the level of training.
Yeah.
Well, it's also not what I guess I would say is setting up every stream is...
It wouldn't be that
frustrating if it was just you plug it in and then you're going. Some of it is just the... There's little gremlins in the computer that just doesn't... They don't want to cooperate each time. And today, I thought I'd be able to set up... I got a green screen. I thought I'd be able to... quickly get it up and going, and instead spent an hour or so trying to follow tutorials, and most of the tutorials are also PC based, and I'm on a Mac. So it doesn't necessarily help me out that much. And then trying to find the right way of doing it. But then, you know, also now we gotta download a whole bunch of other programs and apps and it's just not a lot of fun. I'm gonna be able to sit down and just start going. Setup. This is the digital setup. In the traditional setup, I have running off of my laptop and my iMac.
No, I only have two Macs.
I have an iMac, which is what I'm running off of right now, which is what I run my base, the base foundation OBS. And I have a PowerBook Pro that I use in my drawing area, a traditional drawing setup area. The PowerBook Pro, I'm running a shared screen, so everything's still running off the iMac, but I'm able to control it from the laptop, but there's still a little bit of a delay in that respect. Also, when I run things off of my iMac, I typically unplug everything. So I unplug
the Cintiq that I'm working on.
I unplug the scanner, any peripherals, just so that I can get every single computing power and to minimize the strain on the iMac. I don't know if that makes any sense. The iMac is a late 2012 iMac 1.7 or i7. So it should be barely enough to run everything. And I've also checked with my internet provider. I'm running speeds at over 100 download and 10 megapixels upload. So it should be more than enough. Some of the looking up is just the remembering of looking up. Again, without doing this regularly, there's different aspects definitely not Dylan. Do you stream as well, or do you just watch a lot of streamers? I don't remember. Some of it too is also finding, I guess there are peaks of time where there are a lot of people on. So it's a little bit, probably a little bit more efficient to pick up new followers, to build a channel, to build a stream around those times. But then sometimes those times don't necessarily correlate with the times I have available to draw.
Oh, shit. It's my turn to draft. Left. Alright. Completely missed out on that. I think I need to pick up a quarterback. Derek Carr is available. And fill out the rest with running backs. Some running backs. So I'm thinking, let's see, who are the best available? Yeah, people are saying there's changes around the horizon. I have no idea what they are. I think they're supposed to happen after quote unquote TwitchCon. Anybody have any sleeper picks that they want to throw at me? I need a deep sleeper running back pick. Deontay Freeman, you can see on the screen who's available right now. Who I'm looking at. Spencer Ware, is he?
I can only imagine if I was a professional football player and there was some guy somewhere that I don't know at all talking about me, wondering if they should select me for the next pick on their fantasy football team. It must be really trippy. I think I remember a few years ago somebody tried a fantasy version of comic book pros, and it was kind of interesting. There was a fantasy version with football pros. I don't know. Do you guys remember that? Yeah. And you get the pick, and then based off of the sales that month of the book that they worked on, is how you accumulated stats. So it's almost like you get to a fantasy comic book company. Get to select a couple different writers and artists, and then I think back then it was just artists. I don't remember if writers were included on this. And it's a monthly
monthly thing. I mean, it was kind of interesting. It's kind of fun.
I don't think it lasted more than a year or so. This might have been in the early 2000s.
So I can only imagine right now me being Deonta Freeman and, you know, he's an NFL running back, worked his ass off his entire life, from youth through high school, through college, now in the NFL. To get a spot on a team, to be paid, whatever. But, you know, aside from that, it's just the amount of work and the fortitude that he's gone to, had to go through to get to where he is, for an opportunity to play, not just to show off his physical ability, but to overcome injuries and whatever. All these different factors. And then there's some guy wondering, like, should I pick him to be on my team? You know, like, every single one of these guys should deserve to be on anybody's team. And I think it would be, do you think these players pick themselves? No, of course. I mean, I would pick myself. Maybe not the first round, if I want to win, if I know I'm not getting a lot of playing time. But you got to pick yourself at some point. Because you also believe that you're going to be playing, and that if you do play, that you're going to do well. Nobody thinks they're not going to do well. Nobody thinks that they don't belong, that you have to. I mean, it's part of this, to be at that level where you're in the NFL or you're in a professional league, you have to have so much confidence in yourself. So who am I to wonder if Deonta Freeman is, you know, quote unquote, good enough to be on my team? I mean,
actually, there's a guy after him, Giovanni Bernard. Like, I've never had him on my team, and I always wanted the same guy with my name. See, that's just my own ego. And he's still playing, and, you know, he's...
He's still doing well. Devontae Booker. Royce Freeman.
I mean, Royce Freeman is still the 1-1-2. Okay, my pick's coming up, so...
Let's see. And Derek Carr is available. Quarterback. Derek Carr versus Dax Prescott. Dax Prescott had a great... year 2 years ago. Okay, my pick.
He's on the... Oh, he's going to miss the first six games.
Alright. I sucked at,
Mr. Booker and Mr. Carr. I have three more picks left. One is going to be a kicker. Two are going to be backups. Again, anybody has a sleeper running back pick, I am all ears. Maybe a handcuff to someone. And the thing is, like, watching preseason is very, very deceptive. Because guys can look like studs in preseason, but when they have to go against the number one defense, I think I will pick up Wayne Gallman. Who's the number two running back in LA? Does anybody know?
Malcolm Brown. Damn, should have taken Malcolm Brown. I hope he's still available. Fuck. When you think about these things, way too late.
All right, well, I'm going to give maybe another 10-15 minutes left in this draft. The next two picks, it's going to be another 5 minutes before the next two picks. Trying to get as much done on this as I can. Hopefully I can finish this Purdue Pete piece sometime soon. Eventually post it online. Yeah, definitely not Dylan. I've been picking my bench players now the last couple of rounds. These are guys that, you know, that might play once or twice. They might not play at all. Or they might become superstars. So, you never know. Most of these guys now are bench players themselves in real life. But, you know, in football, injuries are a big part of the game, unfortunately. And especially in certain specific positions like running backs. There's always one or two guys that kind of go down early in the season. Yeah, fantasy football can be pretty fun. I started playing this when I was... and I don't think I've gotten that much better, too. But I've been playing this for like 20-some years. Back in the mid to late 90s. back when we had to... you had to wait until the next day and get the newspaper. Because there was no online confirmation of scoring. So you had to wait the next day, get the newspaper, go through the newspaper, add up all your stats. And then phone it in to the commissioner. It was actually a lot of work. Nowadays, it's just point and click.
Is coming up soon. There's four more guys I have to draft in front of me. Javorius Allen. Malcolm Brown. And Wayne Goleman are still available. Fingers crossed. Malcolm Brown will still be available. I need to pick him up as a safety. Yeah, you know, fantasy football at first was not the most, it all really started with rotisserie baseball, fantasy baseball. I think that was a big kind of thing because baseball is very stats-oriented, it's very numbers-oriented, a lot of people go to the games.
I remember even myself go to the game, and part of going to the game or watching the game was to keep stats
yourself.
Was to be a personal statistician. You would go with a scorebook and sit there and follow along the game.
And record strikes, balls, 3-2, 2-1, out, whatever. Shortstop to second base to first base or whatever. And that was a part of. Alright, Malcolm Brown is available. It's my pick. Okay, one more pick. Wayne Goleman or Javorius Allen? Take Wayne Goleman. Alright, now I actually just need to pick up a kicker. Steven Huska plays in Buffalo. Let's see, 50 plus Jake Elliott.
Okay. All right, I think I got one more pick left, but it's gonna be a little bit. Maybe I'm almost done with this piece here. How many of you guys play, any of you guys out there play in fantasy football? The thinking that I've gotten, or the rumor is, or I shouldn't say rumor or the thinking, but the feeling out there is that this year, and probably since last year, daily draft football has become a little bit more prevalent. And that's where you pick a new team every week.
That's too much work for me.
Yeah, there are people that, because it was actually ruled a sport, was it a sport or is ruled a game of skill, not gambling, a few years ago. Which, I mean, I don't know. I don't really agree with, but. Because on the basis that, you know, if you're going to ban online poker, but you're going to allow, which even that was like supposedly very shady, right? The decision to ban online poker. But that all the, you know, that this is a daily fantasy football, weekly fantasy football is a,
back out, last pick. Last pick of the draft. Oh, Daniel Carlson's available. Minnesota kicker. Oh, I gotta choose Daniel Carlson because I have him on my other team. Yeah, there is a ASMR aspect to each one of my streams. Especially if Jim Chung is on. Because he's really into this kind of stuff. And for me, all I have to do is just rub my beard against the mic. It's actually a good feeling. It's almost like I'm brushing my beard. Okay. Daniel Carlson, kicker, Minnesota. Completed. I think I got a pretty good team. Drew Brees, Mike Evans, Will Fuller, Nelson Aguilar, Todd Gurley, Alex Collins, Travis Kelce, Marshawn Lynch, Adrian Peterson as my two flex. I got Kenny Stills, Devontae Parker when he comes back. Obviously, I'm a Dolphins fan. Austin Eckler. I think I'm a little weak in the running back position. Devontae Booker. Malcolm Brown. Wayne Gallman. These are both. Austin Eckler, I think I picked too early. There's Bryant. Could be the sleeper pick. This could be a sleeper pick. Derek Carr is my backup quarterback. I don't know why he's been ranked so low. I feel like he should be having a monster year. But we'll see. No guys with speeding tickets on my team, yes. And other kind of charges. Alright, well, let's see. Let me finish out this Purdue Pete with the
the hammer. Thank everybody for joining us today, or joining me today,
tonight.
I need to return back to my regular work. You can return back to whatever it is that you're doing earlier, or sleep. Make sure you hit the follow button so you'll be notified next time I come on. I'm going to try to set a more regular schedule so you guys can expect when and where to find me. Got a lot of games planned, or activities, or bits for the actual stream.
Good night, definitely not Dylan. Good night, everybody else.
Thanks for tuning in.
I'll keep you updated on how my football team does throughout the season. All right, good night.